Hi and welcome to another short discussion. This time we're going to be talking about our own coaching philosophies. So Smalley says that a coaching philosophy is extremely important because it is the standard by which a coach can evaluate themselves and has accountability for their methods and results. So what are your guys' coaching philosophies? What you strive to do in your coaching?
Well, the main thing for me is I really want to keep all my participants safe. You could have the best session ever, however, if everyone is in danger or other people get hurt, they're not going to come back next session, especially if it's a child, if their parent sees them at the end of the day, they've got cuts and bruises all over themselves, or even if they just hear that they were put at risk and they're doing something that wasn't safe, even if the child loved what they were doing, they will not bring that child back. So really, at the end of the day, it's all about safety. Yes, definitely try and have a good and entertaining session and get them to learn and develop skills. But for me, keeping everyone safe and in a secure environment is number one for me.
I think health and safety is very important in any coaching session, in any environment as a coach. Or, you know, we want all our participants, whether it be children or disability, sport or adults up to open age, we do want them to be safe. I think, me personally as a coach, I like to be aware of what my participants' needs are. So for me, it's all about participation and the participants that are in the sessions. So for me as a coach, I want to know everything about them. So I want to know their knowledge level, where they're at as a participant, so then I can improve them. So for me, for my coaching sessions, are all about the participants. Whether changing the coaching style from constraints or to participant led and stuff like that, I believe as a coach I can adapt, and that's what I always try and strive for, to make sure that the participants are always improving.
Yeah, I agree with both of those really. I think they're both massive parts, but personally I think my main philosophy is making sure that the participants are having fun. If they're having fun, then I feel like their learning is going to be improved. And with regards to safety, I feel that's more of a responsibility rather than actual like philosophy. So it's something that I would just try and cover as much as I can anyway.
So how would you go about ensuring fun? So we're trying to. I agree with the concept of, you know, we want, especially children's age. That's what I'm guessing your coaching philosophy is aimed at. If we're, how can you make it fun, but make sure that they're enjoying it as well, but actually learning something from the session?
Like you said, with your philosophy, I think a lot of the fun part of learning is participation. So keeping everyone involved, making sure there's no long pauses, like trying to do more of a games-based approach rather than drills, because then you can keep everyone moving and doing stuff at the same time rather than having one person like dribbling a ball in and out of some cones. And then you've got five kids just standing there waiting for a few minutes while it's waiting for it to be their own go.
Yeah.
And I think with regards to their learning, it fun improves your learning, because I feel like when I'm enjoying doing something, I listen more to what I'm being told and I explore new things a bit more. And then that's a better way to learn than sitting there and having information drummed at you.
Yeah, so do you think if with children, if you don't have fun, and again, to you, Steve, as well, if we don't have fun in sessions with children, do you think there's a disengagement? Is there the opportunity to disengage and want to drop out of the sport? Or do you think fun is the be-all and end-all? Or is the room to actually be like specific in drills and sport?
I think drills have their place, but that's more when you're trying to actually improve a skill like really quickly.
Yep.
And going for more blocked practice. But
I wouldn't say fun is be all and end all, but at the end of the day, you do a sport. I mean, effectively it's a pastime or hobby at this, you know, when you begin doing it. So, you know, if you don't have fun at the start and carry on, like, having fun, you're not going to carry on with it. You're therefore not going to improve. And straight off the bat, if you're not enjoying a session, you know, there is the opportunity for you just to stay at the back of the class, do your own thing. You know, you won't be involved, you won't, you know, do all the things that are relevant to that sport. You know, you won't make friends with the class, you won't have anyone to talk to, you won't, you won't want to join in. Any drills you'll find boring, you know. So yes, fun is an extremely important part to coaching philosophy.
I think that's quite a good point. I think if you look at the four square model in football, you've seen a lot of this kind of in coaching football. You know, it's split up into your different sections, and obviously one of those big sections is the social aspect. You know, especially with children, we want to coach. We want to coach that social aspect. That's a big part, like you just said, Dennis. You know, the social aspect is big. If we're not getting them to engage and talk and be friends, they're not going to work as a team on the football pitch. You know?
Yeah,
I see that quite a lot. At under sevens, it's me. I want the ball, and there's not really a problem with that because that's what they used to do at that age. It's when we start getting a little bit older, we want to try and move away from that and get them more into passing and more working as a team. But the social aspect, the fun aspect is very important with that also, So moving on to that, is there anything else you think that's massive in your coaching philosophy?
Not really. I think, like I said, fun's the main thing. I think a lot of other things are almost like roles and responsibilities of a coach.
Yeah.
Like making sure they are safe, making sure they're learning, all that sort of thing. I think that's just stuff that is more expected from a session. But when it comes to how much enjoyment they're actually getting out of it, it's almost like that isn't something, although you, as a parent or whatever, you'd want your kids to be having fun when they're participating in a sport. But it's almost like when you're looking at a session and you think, oh, well, that looks good, like a drill, that looks good to a parent, so they'll think, oh, they're doing that. But if you're doing a game, it looks a little bit more unstructured, but they're having more fun,
so
they can still be learning.
Yeah, like you said, this is more of a role responsibility. I completely agree with that, what you're saying. However, one thing that I think is really important whilst you're coaching is that you have to almost be like a role model, especially if you're coaching children. You have to remember that these kids, you'll probably be one of the only adults that they sort of see a lot of that's not outside their like own family, you know. So this is what they see other adults in the outside world as, apart from teachers or like their parents or friends' parents. So you really got to conduct yourself in a good way. You know, you're setting almost an example of what outside life will be like for them, and for what other people that they might not have, you know, known since a very young age will act about. You know, so you got to conduct yourself in a right way. You know, treat everyone fair and all that stuff. Yes, this is more like on your, you know, not really how you coach, but it's more like how you know how you are around the children and what type of message you portray to them.
I think that's a really good point. I mean, looking at obviously in terms of philosophy and coaching, and obviously everyone's got a different thought on what they expect to be or what they perceive themselves to be the main part of coaching. You know, if we asked 100 people, we'd probably get 100 different opinions. In terms of me, I believe that obviously my coaching style needs to change depending on the ability and the age group. Do you think the philosophy changes when working with different age groups, or do you think your coaching philosophy kind of stays the same, but you tinker it a little bit for the group, or do you think it changes completely?
I would say you only change it a small amount. Just like, say, you were saying how it's going to be fun. Like if you were trying to make a fun activity for under sevens, you know, it'd be quite, you know, laughing and very light-hearted. However, then if you were to the next hour have under 15s, they're going to be a lot older, a lot more mature. They don't want to be babied. You don't want to be like, oh, hey, let's run to this corner. How fun will that be? You know, might work for under sevens, but they're just going to feel like you're just treating them as a young child. So yes, change it slightly, you know, but like the idea of fun is still there, but it's portrayed in a different manner. So yeah, I would say you change it slightly. However, I would say keep the same philosophy. Just like, you know, if you drove a different car, you wouldn't obey different rules to the road. You might drive slightly differently, but you'll still, you know, you'll still drive on the correct side of the road and wait at a red light. You know,
yeah. Yeah, I agree with that. I mean, with regards to fun, it is like you do tinker it slightly. Obviously, at a younger age, they're not going to be as much interested in the actual sport as older participants will be. So it's more like just trying to keep them participating, trying to keep them having fun. But when you get into older lads, probably sort of like 15, 16, 17, that sort of age, they're more going to be interested about trying to win games and things like that. Mm. So although you will want them to still be having fun at training, otherwise, again, you can still get people dropping out or changing teams more likely at that age, I would have thought, rather than just completely dropping out of the sport. But you'd almost try and tinker it more at that age so that you can try and strive to win games more, I think, but you'd still be trying to do that in a fun way.
Yeah, okay, cool. So yeah, so I think like you said, the coaching philosophy can change, but for me personally, I think my coaching philosophy kind of stays the same across the board. So no matter what age group, I'll still always try and give the participants the opportunity to learn by themselves. So for me, I trial and error, so you know, using different techniques. So I do use a bit of block practice if I'm trying to gain a skill, and we might do it over a couple of weeks. But again, like you said before, I'll try and make the activities fun, because that's what we want. Even like you said, open age and stuff, the activity is not fun, and it's, well, we're doing this drill again, you're going to lose the participants that way anyway, you know, because we're all human, we don't like to do things that we find boring, especially when it becomes repetitive. So for me, it's giving the participants the opportunity to develop themselves as well, so through trial and error and through just having a go. And I think, obviously, we've talked previously about creativity and things like that. You know, I think if we don't give our participants the opportunity to try new things, try new skills, try new positions, try new sports and things like that, you know, sections from different sports, then we're not going to get any creativity from our players. We're not going to get a creative, and we come to major tournaments when players get into professional games, and we don't have that creativity. And like you said, when it comes to trying to win matches, they struggle, because we're, as a coach, and we see it on the sidelines all the time, a coach is telling the players what to do instead of letting them play and work out the decisions for themselves.
Yeah. I feel like it's almost, you could almost use an analogy of a farmer. If he puts some seeds in the ground, that's what he's going to get up at the end of the harvest. You know, he's planted wheat, he's not going to get tomatoes, so he's only going to get the end result of what he coaches into those children. So if he doesn't allow them space to grow and develop as an athlete, or care about them learning new skills and stuff like that, you know, they're just going to pretty much stay at the same level, you know. So you've almost got to think about the end product at the end of the day. Yeah. So that's been our video on our own coaching philosophies. I hope you've enjoyed that.